Okay, so Mass has started, the priest is at his chair, and he's greeted the people, "The Lord be with you." What happens next? Next, we take a moment to acknowledge the fact that God has called us from the busyness of our lives, from everything that we carry with us, the weight of the world, and he calls us to set that aside so that we can best worship him. So the priest says, "Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries." What the priest is saying there is, we need to recognize the fact that we're not worthy to be doing this. We'll say that again throughout the Mass. But God still calls us to celebrate these sacred mysteries. What does the church mean when she says mystery here in this context? It's not something that's like, oh, I don't know what that is. It's so mysterious. Call Sherlock Holmes. I have no idea how to solve this. When the church speaks of mystery right here, there's really three levels. The first level is God's plan from all time that we would be saved. It's his thought from the very first moment that we would be with him forever. That's the first mystery, the mystery of God's plan of salvation. The second level of that mystery is Jesus Christ himself. Jesus became incarnate. He became one of us. He walked among us. He became a human, suffered, died, and rose again for us. That's the second level of mystery, the mystery of Jesus' incarnation. And the third level of mystery that is included in that term when the church says to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries is the mysteries of the sacraments. Now, in the Eastern churches, they call the sacraments mysteries. So there's seven mysteries, just as we have seven sacraments, more or less. Some people don't like to put a number on it. So there's a sense of, by performing these ritual actions, these prayers, we're somehow participating in the incarnation of Jesus Christ, that mystery, and the mystery of God's plan of salvation from all time. All of that is included in those priests' words. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. And then what follows is a chance for us to say sorry. Here at Our Lady of Lourdes, what this most often looks like is a series of statements. And the statements themselves can change, but our response remains the same. Sometimes you might hear me say something along the lines of, "You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy." And now we all have the chance to respond, "Lord, have mercy." It's the church's way, again, even though it's not our normal way of speaking, of saying, Lord, I recognize that you're here to forgive me. I'm sorry. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. Recognizing who Jesus is, how he prays for us, how he intercedes for us, and we say, I'm sorry. Now, this isn't a chance for us to beat ourselves up. Oh, I'm so terrible. I'm such a sinner. Oh, woe is me. Oh, I'm a terrible, terrible human being. No, that's not the point of this. The whole point of this is to recognize who God is. God is the one who forgives. So right at the beginning of Mass, we take this moment to pause and reflect on the fact that we are unworthy, and yet he still calls us because he is the one who forgives. He has mercy on us. And then at the end of this penitential act, the priest will say, "May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life." May he be the one who forgives. Through that forgiveness, may we be brought to the eternal life that he has planned for us. This is the mystery that we celebrate, God's plan of salvation from all time. That right at the very beginning of Mass, we recall this fact that God wants to forgive us, and he wants us to be with him forever in eternity. Now, if you ever go to the sacrament of confession, which I would strongly recommend, you may notice that there's a parallel between these words that the priest speaks and the prayer of absolution that the priest prays in the sacrament of confession, of reconciliation, of penance. These are not, technically speaking, words of absolution. This doesn't absolve sins when the priest says this at the beginning of Mass, but there's echoes here. There's a connection here between this sacrament, the sacrament of the Eucharist, and the sacrament of confession. These words are a reminder of what God wants for us: mercy, forgiveness, and everlasting life. What a great way to begin celebrating the Eucharist.